Hi guys, Todd back here. This section of the video is on the first flush downspout water diverter. I just refer to it as first flush. The whole purpose of this is to take out toxins and other pollen and stuff like that. Smaller stuff that you get with the first flush oil and stuff like that that come off a roof when it first rains. Generally that's going to come down in the first couple of gallons, and this system will lock it and trap it and prevent it from going into your water storage system. So what I'm going to do is take all the contents out of this package, and then I'm going to actually put a system together using clear pipe that I bought right here, and I cut off two pieces, and hey, you'll see how all that comes together. After I take it out of the bag, I will use this pipe to put it together, and then I'm gonna come over here and I'm actually gonna use the hose and fill it up and show you how it works. And in order to do all that, that would be near impossible to do myself, I'm gonna have my lovely daughter and camera lady here hold the camera for me and take the rest of this video for me. So thank you, Carly. Pass it off to her. Okay, so let's take everything out here. In a gutter system itself, if you don't have a downspout already, you can put this in, and that allows it to go directly to 3-inch PVC instead of the normal gutter. We will not be using that. These two pieces here are for mounting it, if you have a way to mount it, so you're gonna be horizontally or vertically and just have something going on in the corner. I have never used those. What I have used for mounting are these pieces right here. And when I'm going vertically, I have a wall right here. I attach it and the pipe goes through the center right there. So you do get two of those with the package. You get a T connector, and I will show you exactly what that is in a moment. You get a ball, and this is the key piece that stops all of the crap from going into your water storage system. So we'll use that with the tea later. The hardware here goes with your mounting hardware stuff, so we will not use that. And then we have your slow release gaskets. I forget exactly what they call it, but I don't know if we can zoom in here, but there's 8 of them. Each one has different size holes in it. So the red are a little bit larger and the black are a little bit smaller. You put in the one of these that based on your system size to control the amount of water that goes out. You want as little water as possible going out so that you're not wasting water, and most of it goes into storage, but you don't want to have the hole so small that it clogs up with stuff that goes through. So you kind of have to adjust that based on your system and your environment. Okay, so also what goes in the T is the, I believe this is called the ball stop, and I will actually install this right now. So we will have a T connection. This piece right here installs like this. If I can get it installed, it's a little bit tricky here. There we go. So it just sits in there like that. And the theory is that this ball sits in a 3-inch PVC. As the PVC fills up, it sets neatly in this stop right here, and that's what holds the contaminants in the system down below. So we'll come back to that system later. The bottom of the PVC is this assembly right here, which is actually a couple of things going on. So this piece right here actually glues onto the bottom of the 3-inch PVC. You have your screw piece here, and there's a little rubber O-ring in there. You got to make sure that centers up, and that screws on. And then we have this piece on the bottom right here, which connects up to your hose. And what we're going to do with that is, and for show purposes, I'm going to go with the larger gasket here, and we're going to put it facing down like that, so it's flat at the top, and then we're going to screw that back on. And what we're going to do is have this on top, this on bottom, a PVC in between. The PVC fills up with water. This is going to slowly drain it, and that's what makes it automatic for you. In order to keep any crap from clogging up though, take this back out, we're going to put our last piece in, which is a filter here. And the filter just simply goes up in between, just like that. and then we screw this on. So that's what keeps our little gasket from clogging up. Okay, that's it. Toss the package aside for right now. Oh, actually, before I toss the package aside, let me show you. There are lots of directions on here and pictures if I hold them right side up. Actually, one side's right side up, the other one's upside down. There are lots of directions and pictures showing you. You have lots of options. You can do horizontally, vertically. You can do multiple tubes going back and forth so that you can have a larger first flush system depending on how much water is coming in. And all of that is explained on here with different options. It's tough. Let's see. Let me go this way. Lots of different options here. So I'll take pictures and include this in the blog post so you can get a little better view of what they include here. So with this, let me go ahead and put a system together. So if I can get my camera person to stand back a little here, what I'm gonna do is this is gonna be my vertical piece here. It is going to basically fit right in here tight. And normally you would glue this. Because this isn't glued, it may leak on me. If that's the case, I will temporarily use duct tape just for display purposes here. Then the T, before the T goes in, you put the ball in the center so it can float. You put the T on top, and don't forget the ball valve right here has got to be facing down. So let me get that in. This piece right here would be coming from the roof or from your gutter system. That's your input. And then going out the side, this goes to your water storage system. And that would be our system. So I'm going to go ahead and run some water in here. And Carly, you might do better to try to pan out from over here. So what I want to do is fill this up, assume the contaminants are going to be in here, and then the water will eventually go out the side piece there. You can see the ball is filling up. Murphy's about to get a shower and he doesn't even know it. I am getting a little bit of water coming out of the bottom, but not too bad. Here we go, Murph. And that's what happened. Whoops. Well, that wasn't exactly designed. But you get the idea of how the system works. We fill it up, all the contaminants go into the tube itself. We lock them in, the ball locks it in the tube itself, and then everything else goes into your storage device. So that's it for this video. Please consider subscribing to our YouTube channel. Also consider going to greatescapefarms.com, subscribing for our email. Thank you very much to our camera lady, Carly. Have a good day.